Today's expert has combined very successfully several passions that she has. First of all, the pet industry, pets, technology, and being a vegan. Paula Mesteller is a graduate of the University of Colorado. She spent the early part of her career marketing accounting software applications for large corporations. She continued her career in the corporate world in the commercial marketing at the Boeing Company in Renton, Washington. On a whim, Paula accepted a position working for a web development company where she discovered her passion for web development and applications. Then Paula decided it was time to go solo. She decided to combine her love of animals and helping people grow their businesses with the help of software. Paula and her longtime workmate and friend, Paul Narrow, joined forces to create Pet Exec. Paula now lives in sunny Arizona. She's married and the mother of two grown children. She represents the pet industry and being vegan in a very unique way. Enjoy the show.
Welcome to the Vegan Visibility Podcast Show, where your host, Kathleen Gage, shines the spotlight on vegan and plant-based businesses and entrepreneurs from all walks of life committed to cruelty-free eating, healthy lifestyles, animal compassion, and the environment. Enjoy the show.
So Paula, you are kind of an anomaly where you actually have a business that's all around the pet industry, and you're also a vegan, which is honestly kind of a rare combination, which is somewhat surprising. So we're going to dig into that today, but let's start with you sharing about your business and what you do and when you went vegan.
Oh, okay. That sounds great, Kathleen. And thank you for having me on your show. I have owned a pet business. It's basically pet business software. So people get that confused. They think that I own a dog daycare. But if you think about a business and the structure of a business, they would need software to manage appointments, grooming, training, boarding, and whatnot. And so our software manages that for not just the pet owner, but the pet parents. So I have been doing that for 15 years, actually. But even before that, I was a web developer. So I've always been very interested in technology and animals. But I have been a vegan for a long time. So even in my 20s, I did not eat red meat. And then I just kind of, a lot of like what people, I think, tend to do is they do this in stages. I did not eat red meat. And I think it was probably at least 15 years ago, I stopped eating chicken. And then 10 years ago or more, stopped eating fish. And along with that, I think a lot of people don't realize that a lot of the clothing you wear, purses, shoes, things like that, you should always get a, you know, there's a lot of really nice vegan leather options instead of
like what I'm wearing right now. It's a
yes,
it's
and you look leather. Lovely. Yes. As always, Kathleen.
Thank you.
But it's, you know, so I always get compliments when on my purses, and they always think I spent, you know, $1,000, which I would never do anyhow. But it's interesting that people are starting to realize, and I always say, oh, it cost me $40 and it doesn't use any animal products at all. So,
well, let's talk about why that's important. Before we go any further, I want to remind people that you're listening to the Vegan Visibility Show. This is Kathleen Gage, and I'm talking with Paula Mesteller, and she is the CEO of Pet Exec Inc. And you can find the company at petexec.net. That's petexec.net. We'll put that in the show notes. But you know, I've worked in the pet industry for quite a while, and I have to say the first time that I actually keynoted at a conference, I assumed that there would be no chicken, meat, pork, anything on the plates. And I have to say I was surprised. And and at the time I was a carnivore, so, you know, who am I to talk? But I expected. And now, you know, when I go to conferences, it's been a while, obviously, because of the pandemic, but I'm noticing a change. So let's talk about your involvement in being a vegan and how that actually integrates nicely into the pet industry and what you're doing to raise awareness around that.
Oh, I've got such a great story for you, Kathleen. I remember that conference because you interviewed me then. And I did tell them, I said, do you know, I'm a vegan. I pay the same as everybody else. There was not one thing I could eat. So as a vegan, you always do these different things. Like I always have to bring food behind the booth and all of this. But I also brought it up to the IBPSA, which I was at the conference a couple of months ago. And they said they had more compliments about what they, the spread that they offered than any other year. And do you know, it was vegan friendly, hummus, rice, salads with, you know, dressing on the side, because of course vegans, a lot of these dressings have dairy products in it, which I call the antichrist of foods. If you're going to give up anything, I mean, dairy is a great one to start off with, because your health will, you will feel better immediately by giving up those dairy products, as well as being nice to our friends, the dairy cows, who don't have a very good existence if you're drinking their milk, which is kind of gross when you think about it. But yes, it was really amazing. And I had to compliment them. And I said, do you know, it was so nice, because I'm just so used to like having to kind of look and, oh, I can't eat that. Oh no, they put cheese on the salads. They always do that. They put feta cheese, and I go, right, I can't eat that now. So I've had times where I go through the whole line and I just got to go sit down, and I just don't get to eat until, you know, the conference is over. But that's changing, Kathleen. I really think it's changing. In fact, I have a few friends that, they watched a special on Netflix, and they're certainly not your typical vegan, persona. And when they watched, it's not just, you know, if, you know, we're all animal lovers, especially in this industry. But I think that people just don't realize the extent of not only how unkind it is and how cruel it is to the animals that that you eat, but also how cruel it is to your own bodies. Because if you notice, there's such an uptick of autoimmune deficiencies. Everybody's got arthritis. Everybody's got things like, I'm, you know, a woman that's, I'm way over my mid-50s. I've never had a hot flash or menopause symptoms or anything like that. I don't have the typical aches and pains that all my friends do that are not vegans. And I just don't have them. I just don't. And I just don't have some of the normal issues that other people have. And when they ask me, they go, oh, you, my husband says, you're the only person I've ever known. You never get an injury. You're never in pain. I said, I attribute it to being a vegan. I absolutely do.
Absolutely.
When you're a business owner like you, Kathleen, you have to be on camera. I have to give presentations all the time. You have to be on, right?
Right.
It's mentally, you have to be mentally sound and clear. And then it gets harder as you get older a little bit, you know?
Well, I'm going to be hitting 68 for my next birthday. And I went on a 3-mile run this morning, you know, so
see what I mean.
You know, I got to tell you, I think I'm just a little over 2 years from 70. And it's like, how did that happen? And yet I feel healthy. I feel vibrant. I go on runs. I eat super healthy, but I really do want to give a shout out to Carmen, because she and I did have a conversation with one of the conferences. And I said, look, I'm plant-based now. I didn't call myself vegan at the time. I was plant-based. And now I'm a proud vegan, but I said, is there any way that I can have choices around plant-based meals? And she was very accommodating. Same thing. She said highest ratings on the buffet. And Delicious. It's interesting, because there's a lot of closet vegans. And what that simply means is they think that they're going to be rocking the boat if they ask for what they need. And we have to ask for what we need, because, you know, the way I describe it, we're at the edge of a cliff right now with our climate, with our health, with our economy. There is so much wrong right now that we can right by making simple changes. And one is to be more vocal about the connection between animal products, consuming animal products, and fixing all those problems. Because I know that they're talking about waiting till 2030 to make changes. It's like, we can't wait. We cannot wait. So as an influencer within the pet industry, what do you see as some changes that could take place to educate people? Because quite seriously, I've talked to people in the pet industry, and I've had a few of them get kind of upset with me. It's like, oh, we only eat compassionately farmed animals. And it's like, yeah, but they're still dead. You know, it's like
they still go to the same slaughterhouse. And most people just don't realize.
Right.
A lot of it, Kathleen, is I think people need to realize that if they look at TV, every other ad is for a medicine, right? It's some kind of drug because you have high cholesterol and stuff like that. I go, you know how to get rid of a lot of those health issues and things like that? Because big pharmacy makes a lot of money off of meat eaters, right?
I see your little Poochie there.
Oh yeah, that's my foster family.
I always welcome animals into the interviews.
Well, she's a very special dog to me. She's a foster fail from last year. She was very sick when she came to me, had just had puppies. She had kennel cough, the whole bit. She was, it was horrible just to see her. And then we fell in love with her, but now she's ours. We could not find a family for her, but anyhow, but I think people in the pet industry, because we don't typically in this culture eat dogs, it's terrible to think about eating dogs, but I go, what's the difference between a dog and eating a steak when you can't see where it's come from? So I think the more people understand, Kathleen, that there is somebody who was just living in unbelievably horrible conditions in order to create the amount of food needed by factory farming. And most of the food you eat, the meat that you're not really thinking, you know, you just have been eating it your whole life. Most of those animals have never seen the light of day, and they see absolutely filthy conditions. And when they eat filthy things, guess what? You're eating that same stuff. And it does have a trickle-down effect on your health, the way you look, your aging process, and your mind, your mental. If you want to be, you know, strong mentally and alert and clear thinker, especially with you, have to be in front of the camera. And I have to say, and I've said this to you many years before, you always look amazing. Nobody would ever guess your age. And you know what? If you're vegan, people look young. People, it's your body is meant to be vegan. People think it's not healthy. And there's some kind of a, oh, you're a vegan. It's kind of like taboo.
Right.
So you start off, you know, plant-based makes it sound like you're a little bit less, you know, because I just really think that people need to know that vegans are happy people. We have fun. We eat delicious foods.
Absolutely.
Not just salads all the time, guys. I promise you, any of your most delicious carnivore dishes, you sit in my house, I will make you something delicious with whole fruits, vegetables, herbs and spices, that sort of thing. It will be more delicious than anything that you would eat in a carnivore environment.
Absolutely.
And you will feel better afterwards. You won't be bloated and you'll be healthier for it.
And, you know, it's interesting because it's also like any community, whether it be Republicans, Democrats, Christians, Catholics, whatever it may be, men, women, you have a variety of types. You know, it's like in the vegan movement, we have the people that they do go to the slaughterhouses and they do water the pigs as they're going on to slaughter. That's their advocacy. Then we have people like the ones who are doing health and nutrition, and they're educating people that way. Then we have people like myself. I do it through my podcast show, and you do it through your business. And so we all have our role, and to realize that we're not all from one mold. And so I'm curious, let's take a step back into your business. Now, you are a software company.
Yes, we
are. Okay. And why would a company within the pet industry, why would they use your services? What's the greatest benefit?
Well, we're all animal lovers, and typically our ideal customer is a pet resort. But pet resorts, just like you were saying, people from all walks of life can be plant-based and vegans. Same way with businesses. I think businesses are starting to realize that like with what we do software for pet resorts, basically, although some people just do boarding, some people just do daycare, or some people just do grooming or training, or do a number of combinations of all of those. Plus you get the pet parents involved in that community. So what we do as a business is we try to make sure that that business has a great, an easier way to communicate. And PetExec does a lot of the integration, communication, marketing, things like that, appointment setting within that business so they can pay attention to the dogs and whatever, other critters. So when you work with animals all day, it just seems like it would be a standard practice, at least in our own, my own mindset is to think about other animals that, why would you eat, you know, why would you eat a chicken and just have a bird as a pet? Do you know what I mean?
I get it.
I'm a scuba diver. You know, I've seen big lobsters walking around just minding their own business. The last thing I would want to do is eat this lobster. And you know, Kathleen, a lot of people think vegans are so unhealthy and all this. I go, do you know, the studies are out. The strongest animals on this earth, the rhinoceroses, chimpanzees, others, hippopotamus, these are all plant-based vegan animals. They're the strongest animals in the animal kingdom. And even on Netflix, they have, you know, shows like What the Health. It doesn't show any horrible scenes that, you know, make you, you know, want to turn your head. Although if you can't stand to watch that and you turn your head, don't participate in purchasing items like that. But they'll show you, they've done many studies. They even do it right there with extreme athletes and how well they do when they turn into a vegan diet. So I just put everybody kind of, I want my clients to be very strong, fit, and healthy. They're working in an environment where they're, you know, picking up animals and they have to be strong and they have to be on their game, you know, training these animals and just being very healthy. You don't want them to have sickness or anything like that. And they're great people. They're business owners. So I want to show them what I've learned. And I feel like we're at an advantage, Kathleen, because we've kind of bucked tradition. You know, people go Thanksgiving, oh, it's this and this and this. I go, I don't eat Thanksgiving turkey.
Right.
So on Thanksgiving, I go, you know how many delicious foods there are? I host parties and stuff. I make delicious, you know, foods with cranberries and all these vegetables and things like that. And it's all very hearty, delicious with sauces. You don't have to eat turkey on Thanksgiving. Change your traditions. And you can change it and be like, there's just so many other healthy options. For example, I'm just going to give you another one. My neighbor, I moved last year in 2020 because aren't you supposed to do everything crazy in 2020? I foster failed, which it's actually not the first time, but anyways, I did move and my, where was I going with this? Oh, my neighbor, her son had a kidney disease and they had to have a kidney transplant. And I told her before they went in for the procedure, I said, please don't eat the crap that people are going to bring to you. You know, when you're sick and they bring you food, so they're going to bring you a lot of meat and pasta and stuff like that. And it's not healthy for your body. Your body's a weak right now. So I made them in nature, kidney beans are very good for your kidneys, right? So I made them things like red beans and rice and all these things where I use, you can use flour that's not made with wheat and glutens that are not good for you either. Everybody has gluten intolerance. They just don't realize it. Some more than others, or dairy intolerance. Most people do. They just have it at different, you know, they just don't notice it as much. So I made him ice cream with coconut milk. He said it was the most delicious thing he ever had. And they know me for that because I go put healthy, high nutrition, healthy foods in your body that are plant-based, nutritious, and then you're not going to have to do things like, do you have to watch your weight and diet all the time?
Me? No. I used to, I actually was about 60 pounds heavier than I am now. And I was a yo-yo dieter. And when I went plant-based, I had given up on diets and the weight just melted off. And I'm like, wow, That's amazing.
You don't have to think about it, because when your body's healthy, it's not going to signal you for more food.
Right.
There are some vegan junk foods and things like that. Don't get me wrong. But if you're eating a solid diet that's very healthy, the chances of you being hungry and not satiated by the food you're eating is much less. And even, you know, I know people that are much, much younger than me, which there are a lot of them, that
wait till you get to me my age. Then there's a whole bunch of them.
That far behind you, but you look amazing. I hope that I look as good as you. It's amazing. But my whole message to, you know, people, business people, pet, in my community is the pet industry, of course, with pet resort owners and people like that, is, you know, just to take a step back and try something new. If you've been eating meat your whole life and you just, oh, how can I live without cheese? That's what people say. Oh, I could never give up cheese. And I go, think about what it is you're eating and then think of the alternatives that are
right, just
delicious and much better for you. So,
you know,
that's my message.
Well, and I really wish that as much money and time and effort were put into educating people around food as there is around the whole pandemic stuff going on. I mean, it angers me, because I look at it and all this money is being thrown at a Band-Aid over the problem instead of getting to the root of the problem. But then when you start pulling the veils away, you realize that there, it's about money. You know, follow the money and you'll see what's really going on. Now, and it's so interesting, because in hospitals, it shocks me that there are fast food restaurants, including McDonald's.
How about the food in hospital? They make more money if you're sick, don't they?
They definitely do. So let's take a step back to the type of businesses you work with, because I didn't know until I got involved with the pet industry that there can be pet resorts that have the capacity for 100 to 200 guests overnight. And by guests, the animal, obviously.
Yes, of course.
You have all the way from the mom and pop operation to large corporations. So what are some of the problems that your software would solve for people? Because when you're running a huge operation, you have to be organized.
You have to be organized. And I'm going to just say, in addition to those, I mean, people will have taxi services. They'll have add-ons to the food. Employees, all this stuff. There's a lot that goes into this business. And it's kind of, in a way, like being a vegan. You know, people look at you a little bit off. When you say you own a pet resort, people think, oh, you're just playing with dogs all day, which we know is not true. Any of you pet resort owners, how hard the work is. But what it does is it keeps you organized. So your employees clocking in, the feeding and medication details, you know, for boarders and pets in daycare and grooming and notes, and all of those kinds of things are taken care of within the software. And one of the big things, because now with this economy, it's harder and harder to find employees, right? They're more expensive. There's all kinds of different rules now where you want to kind of streamline your processes. So what I like to tell people is get, you know how we're all addicted to these things?
Oh, that little thing called an iPhone?
This little thing. what I like to tell people is it's okay. We did not create the addiction, but it's really nice to get your pet parents involved, where PetExec has an app. And we also have an owner portal that's that they can also use on just a regular web browser on any device, basically. So they can go on there, they can schedule appointments for their pets for daycare, boarding, they can request grooming and other services and training classes and all these other sorts of things. They can purchase packages, they can sign contracts, just a plethora of things. You can send them messages, they can see the histories of their messages that they've done in the past. And it's just one less thing that they have to call you. Because at the end of the day, this little device, people are gonna want to look at it. So we have to make it enticing for them and make it something useful and actually kind of fun, easy to use. And so people, and I've had some of my clients say it revolutionizes their life, because they just walk in and everybody's all scheduled, ready to go, and they could just work. And so people know what to do. So it's the automation piece, I think, that really helps save, you know, hundreds and hundreds of hours and time for the employees. Because a lot of times people, I know it sounds strange, Kathleen, but some people do not like sitting behind a computer all day long.
Amazing. Amazing.
Amazing.
You know, that's why I go out on my runs because, you know, and I was just thinking that a whole new segment of the market that's going to open up are those people that they pre-pandemic, they were working in an office. And so they became homebound in a sense. They were working from home. And a lot of them adopted animals. It's like, and many of them got dogs. Well, it's interesting because we have a rescue that we got probably about 4 months ago that this particular combination apparently is one of the highest number in shelters right now. It's a shepherd pit bull mix because people thought it looked like a cool dog, and very high maintenance, extremely high maintenance. We have to run them all the time. And what people did is they got these dogs as the pandemic started happening, and many of them going back to work in an office, they're going, what do I do with my pets? So that's a whole segment of the market that a lot of people would never give up their pet, but they need a solution. So what a great opportunity within the pet industry to serve that market of people who they didn't realize that, yep, someday you're going to go back into an office. And so, you know, I love what you're doing. I love the fact that you're vegan. I love the fact that we've been able to meet real time because very rarely do I get to meet the people that I interview on my podcast show. And in closing, Paula, I again want to remind people, petexec.net, that's petexec.net, and reach out to Paula and she'll give you a tour of the site and she'll help you with your software needs if you're a pet a resort owner and other companies. So Paula, in closing, what are your final thoughts for people?
My final thoughts are, you know, we recognize the need for people to have pets in this community, and people are looking for businesses to take care of their pets now. And you're right, Kathleen. People need more training opportunities. So training, daycare, boarding numbers have increased. And so pandemic or not, people are realizing, even if it's the first time they had a pet during the pandemic, they're realizing how important they are and how impactful they are to our lives. So I just want to say, love the animals, love your pets, and love all animals that are on the planet. And if you want to come over to PetExec and you know, kind of take it, either myself or one of us can take you on a little tour around of the system and kind of see what it's about. We would love to have you there.
Awesome. Well, this has been delightful, Paula, and this is Kathleen Gage with Vegan Visibility, and I encourage you, really check what you're doing every day and think through the whole process of what you put into your body, and is it a kind gesture with every bite that you take? I want to encourage people to go out, do what's right, do what's aligned, and be compassionate. Have a great day.
You've been listening to the Vegan Visibility Podcast Show. Be sure to subscribe to get notified when the next episode is live. And we always appreciate reviews. Join us next time for more inspiration, education, and motivation to build your business one cruelty-free and healthy person at a time.